Taz. I'm Michael Cheat with Mike'sGuitarLessons.com. This is going to be the first video for Maroon 5's One More Night. And this is actually going to be a pretty simple song, so I think I'm going to get the whole song done in this one video. However, I do have tabs for this available at my website and my blog. If you're watching this on YouTube, the clickable links are right below the video. Okay, I've got my Facebook, Twitter, my blog, and my actual website. And just remember, if you go to my blog and you don't see it right at the top, it just means I put other lessons above it. Just scroll down to see all of the lessons, and you can find this one there as well. Alright, let's go ahead and get started. This is actually a really simple song. I do advise getting the tabs from me, because basically it'll just help you memorize it a little bit, but for the most part, this really is pretty easy to memorize. We're going to start off with, I'm going to show you how to play it a couple of ways, depending on how, what level you are on the guitar. Okay, this first way is going to be a little bit easier, and basically the song's going to sound like this. That's it. Believe it or not, the guitar part, that's it. Okay? And it's only two strings we're having to worry about here. And what you're going to do is you're going to put first finger on the skinny E string in the fourth fret, playing that note. Third finger is going to play the sixth fret on the B string, playing that note. And you're going to play it as a chord, so you're going to play both strings at the same time, four times in a row. You want to make note, I'm muting the strings in between each chord. So I play the chord, and then I let my hand, the heel of my hand here, touch the strings so that they mute. You can also let the pressure up on your left hand that's holding the chord. So play that chord four times, and you're going to go to your next chord, okay? And that's going to be third fret. Yeah, third fret on the skinny E string. And then the fourth fret on the B string. Okay? You're going to play that chord twice. And then after that, you're going to slide down two frets. So it's going to be first fret on the skinny E string. Second fret on the B string. You're going to play that chord twice. And that's it. And that really is the entire song. It never changes the chord progression all the way through. So you can get through the entire song just by playing that. Now, if you want to add a little bit more to it, make sure those chords are a little more meaty, you can play it. I've got this on the tabs too. You can play it with these other chords here. You can do a whole bar chord where you're going. Or you can just play the notes that I have on the tabs, which are just these three notes. Okay, let me show you how to do those real quick. This is a bar chord. It's an F minor bar chord. Yeah, F minor bar chord. And what you're going to be doing is barring in the 8th fret, and then you're going to be playing the, barring the 8th fret up to the A string. Don't bar the E string. And you're gonna, your third finger is going to play the 10th of the D string. Pinky's going to play the 10th fret of the G string. Middle finger's going to play the 9th of the B string. And then you're barring the skinny E string and the A string. Okay? Now if you want to, just go ahead and play that whole chord. Like that. Okay? Then we've got a bar chord here where it's going to be, first finger's going to play the 6th fret of the A string. Third finger's going to play the 8th fret of the D, G, and B strings, okay? And that's your second chord, so you're playing that one twice. Then you take that chord, the exact same formation, and slide it down two frets. So now it's first finger on the fourth fret of the A string, third finger on the sixth fret of the D, G, and B. And again, you're not playing the two outside strings, just those four middle strings. But you're going to play that chord twice. And I forgot to mention, I did say this is an F minor, then you have a D sharp, and then it's a C sharp, okay? And you just play it with the same rhythm. Over and over again, okay? Now if you can't play bar chords, it's okay. Just play the D, G, and B strings. Basically, you can do that right there. Actually, to make it easy on yourself, you can just do it just like that. First finger on the B string, 9th fret. Third finger on the G string, 10th fret. Middle finger on the 10th fret of the D string. Just those three. Then when you go to your second chord, you can bar across or just use three fingers. It's a little tight, but you can probably do it. So it's 8th fret on the D, G, and B. And slide that down 2 frets for your C sharp. Okay, so you could play it like that. Or. Okay, now there's a few different ways I showed you how to play it there. Mainly because this song is just so simple. I stretched it out a little bit just to give some of you beginners an alternate way to play it in case it's kind of, it's played with these small chords, but actually if you want to play the bar chords, I wanted to show you how to do that too. So you've got those more full sounding chords if you're playing by yourself. So anyways, that's the entire lesson. Remember the links for the Facebook group, Twitter, my blog where I have the tabs at, and all of my other videos that you want to check out. Not everything's on YouTube. It's on the links that are right below the video. Okay? So, thanks for watching, and good luck.